love pump in and out of your soul. You've got to get it under control. Ah, oh, man, I messed up the melody there. Hey, welcome to Drive Time. This is me, Vernon Hunt, your host. Hey, the Macho of 28th, and this is 21:55 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. It's Thursday. It is colder. It's colder than I thought. Which is upsetting to me, and I was walking my dog, about woman into it, and I realized, oh, the sun is kind of is gone now, and the wind has kicked up, and holy shit, it's a lot chillier out than I anticipated. And just saw my neighbor, I think he's got a new puppy over there.
Guy, I don't know what he does. He never goes to work. He's always home.
That's my job. I want that job. They seem to be having a good time with the monies too, you know? What's that all about? You know, I just wish people knew me and they would just, everyone would give me a dollar. If 50,000 people gave me $1 every year. So many people in the world, and 50,000 is so few, comparatively. And why can't they just give me a dollar? So anyway, it was cold out. I'm like 1 minute into a 50-minute walk, I'm realizing, oh shit. My fingertips are freezing and my ears are cold. And old lady Winter is just hanging on. She's just like, I ain't done yet. I got a cold for another day, dude. That's how I envision the season of winter. If the season of winter were a lady who spoke like that. That was a lady voice, by the way. There's a, hey, my name is Winter. So cold. So cold, chillin'. I could kick, cry, keep your bones cold all night long. Yeah. Oh, it's great to be alive, though. I rectified my overeating. I don't know how I did it. I think I just today, I remember thinking, you know what it is? You plant little thoughts in your head. I planted a thought. And if you plant little thoughts in your head, you'll be better. Because I was thinking, like, just don't, whatever you do tomorrow, just eat a small amount of calories. Just consume less. And so I did. I had a salad of, you know, it wasn't even like a real salad. That's all I ate for lunch, was like a little bit of hummus mixed with carrots, red onions, and like these fancy grape tomatoes that are all different colors, and I sliced them up. And I made like a little bit of mayo and vinegar, and I just swirled it all together. And that was it. That was all I ate. And I had, no, that was it. That's, I think I thought I had like a bite of something. No, that was it. I was gonna have the bread on the side, but I was like, no carbohydrates. Bad. Leaving for Washington D.C. tomorrow, midday. So only probably one program on tomorrow. One program, maybe two. See what we can do. I got a bag of grapefruits I cut up a whole grapefruit. I'm gonna eat that as a snack later. And then I'm gonna run tonight. I really should get it in a long run tonight. Because I'm running a half marathon in almost, you know, a little over a week. Sunday from this Sunday, and today's Thursday. So I need to make sure I'm in shape. So I really need to run like 10 miles. One day coming up here, maybe tonight. Yeah, I mean, why not tonight? It should be not freezing cold, and I don't think it's supposed to rain, so it seems like tonight would be the perfect time to do it. Get some tunes, and you know, prepare myself mentally for that as well, and then just tell yourself you're going to do this when you get home, you're going to do this when you get home, you're going to do this when you get home. Guy walking with a Giants hat on and this little fruity white dog. So I got a haircut yesterday. I left you with that thought. This is episode C. C. Not 20C, but at the end of episode 19D. I talked about just remembering at the last second before I missed the turn to get into the haircut place that I was indeed going to get a haircut. And look, at this point in my life, it's just, it's so clinical, really. There's nothing cosmetic or aesthetic about it. I think all those adjectives apply to what I'm trying to say. Like, I just need to, you know, I need to get the fucking hair, just recycle, you know, get it off my head, and then I'll do it, and I'm like, we'll do this again in 6 months. And I probably got a haircut, I think it was November, so it's probably 3 times a year I get a haircut. So I get it cut pretty short, although every time I ask him, I say, just, yeah, she, like, looks in the thing, it's at Great Clips, and she's like, so you want a 3 on the sides, and I'm like, yes, but, you know, I like it, just keep a little, like, more length on top, because it's my hair's pretty long at this point, so I'm like, shaggy all over the place in my back, and my hair definitely needs a clip, and I like that short, sheer look on the sides, but I also like to keep it some, like, front and the top, I like to have some length, and every time I'm like, well, just, you know, pretty long, keep it, just trim it a little bit, as this cop just cut me off, fucking dick. So they can never get that right. Because they end up just cutting the top really short, too. And it's just way shorter than I wanted, like an inch more left on the top. So I never get to have that look, that functional look. Which is what it is. Like I said, I don't even care anymore. I think this haircut was like an all-time low in terms of me trying to check myself out in the mirror. You ever wonder with people about haircuts and people when are just keeping your hair a certain way? Somebody will be like, you know, usually a significant other or something. Significant other, like the second Limp Bizkit album. They'll be like, oh, yeah, look, you gotta do this, and they'll, like, fix it, and then you look at yourself and be like, that is the exact opposite of how I thought it should go, the hairs. What is this? Is this a cat? Oh, my God. What is that animal? I'm passing the roadkill I talked about in episode 20B, and I look like maybe it was a cat now, who died on top of the squishy raccoon.